Spectacular! Spectacular! No words in the vernacular can describe this great event. You'll be dumb with wonderment.
Hi, Year 11. The music you've just heard is from a Baz Luhrmann film called Moulin Rouge. It's about a struggling artist, Christian, who's trying to make a pitch for his next theatrical spectacular. Well, similar to Christian, I'm here to make my pitch to you about studying performing arts in post-16. We offer the BTEC National Extended Certificate course, which is equivalent to one full A-level. It's a fantastic course, but some of you might be thinking, why study the arts? Well, luckily for me, the Arts Council of Great Britain have undertaken some research to try and answer this question and raise awareness of the benefits of studying the arts. Let's take a look. Some people see the theatre as a laboratory in which we can study the problems that confront society and attempt to solve those problems. Brecht was very keen on this idea, and you'll remember that from your work in Year 8. The Arts Council say that 68% of the UK residents said that the arts made them proud to be British. Students who study arts subjects are more employable and more likely to stay in employment. The arts make communities stronger and more unified. So theatre has many more benefits than just being purely for entertainment. In terms of our mental health and well-being, this is a subject that has been close to my heart and in my mind recently during this COVID-19 pandemic. I've really missed going to the theatre, and it's the first time that theatres have been fully closed since the plague in the 1600s. Performance permeates every aspect of our lives and relationships. We are all actors, whether we intend to be or not. And in this ever-changing digital world, the human body and spirit is still at the heart of everything. We crave those human interactions, the sense of togetherness. Events like clapping on a Thursday night to thank the NHS and key workers have become a new kind of theatre. In terms of our health and well-being, the arts illuminate our inner lives, enrich our emotional world, and teach us compassion. The arts can have a positive impact on specific health conditions like dementia and depression. And almost 60% of people are likely to report good health if they've attended a cultural place or event in the last 12 months. Well-being is higher amongst those who have a higher arts and cultural engagement. During the World Wars and more recently during this pandemic, people have turned to the arts for entertainment, enjoyment and escapism. A way of boosting morale and reminding us what it means to be human. A way to celebrate diversity and empathise with others. A lot of people ask me about job opportunities in the arts, and I'm pleased to say that it is one of the fastest growing employment sectors, contributing £101.5 billion to the economy in 2017. I'm not talking about just being in the acting business. There are many varied and interesting career opportunities for people who've studied the arts. Studying the arts at A-level can lead to a whole host of career opportunities. Previous students have become actors, backstage crew, but many have also become teachers or gone on to work in the civil service or started businesses or work in business, using their drama skills to underpin these successful careers. There are lots of opportunities. Most importantly for me, as a drama teacher, theatre teaches us about people, places and ideas. It teaches us how to express ourselves more effectively. It develops our thoughts and feelings, improves our relationships with each other and the world around us. Secondary pupils are twice as likely to volunteer if they have studied an arts subject. 20% are more likely to vote. Theatre makes us aware and engage with the world around us. And low-income families are more likely to have a child who successfully completes a degree course if they have studied an arts subject at school. There are many, many benefits to studying the arts, and I do hope you'll consider this course as of a benefit to you. Our course consists of 4 units. Now, please feel free to pause the PowerPoint or return to the information to read in more detail. but I do want to give you an overview, so I'll whiz through these units quite quickly. Unit 1 and 2 are completed in Year 12, and Unit 3 and 19 are completed in Year 13. Unit 1 is all about the movers and shakers in the theatre world, the practitioners who have influenced theatre and our perception of theatre. This is a unit set by the exam board, and it is a written exam. Unit 2 is a practical unit where you'll create a performance for a public audience. This unit is all about using your practitioner knowledge in a practical way. You have responsibility here to shape the work, and the onus is on you to make that piece of theatre. In Year 2, you'll undertake a unit in acting skills, exploring different styles of acting and different genre of theatre. Everything from commedia dell'arte, which you experimented with in Year 8, through to more naturalistic acting based around Stanislavski. Your final unit is a practical performance based on a stimulus given by the exam board. This is your opportunity to work in a professional context as a director, actor, or technician. Now, all of the information for these units can be found here and in the next few slides in much more detail. Please do read through, but if you have any questions or require further information, please contact me via email, which you can find at the end of the presentation. In terms of job opportunities and careers, I've already mentioned that people who study the arts, they are more employable than some other people. And the main reason for this is that through the course, you develop teamwork, self-confidence, initiative, an ability to think outside the box, and most importantly, you gain an ability to reflect, to give and take constructive criticism, and inevitably, problem solve. The careers that are available to you are varied and interesting. Here are some pictures to give you a flavour of some of the jobs you might undertake. Lighting, sound, production, costume design, set design, directing, puppetry. And for some of you, you might want to pursue a career as an actor. Even in these unprecedented times of theatre closures, theatre is still thriving. People are streaming theatre, creating new theatre in isolation. I've put a little link at the end of the presentation to a new piece of theatre that was created by students from Leicester de Montfort in collaboration with Gecko Theatre Company. The students embraced the isolation of COVID-19 and created a piece of theatre about their experiences. Please do take a look, it's a very interesting piece of work. Now, what we can offer you? Well, as you know, we have fantastic specialist facilities. Two drama studios, a dance studio, and a 350-seat theatre. We are specialist teachers. We have a fantastic pastoral care system at KESH, and we also arrange a wide variety of trips to see live theatre. We organise professional workshops with theatre companies, and we support your university application and auditions. In terms of what we're looking for from you, well, good attendance and punctuality, a good attitude, focus and enthusiasm, an ability to work within a team, respect for others, ability to take constructive criticism and give constructive criticism, vocal and movement skills, and during the course you'll develop physical stamina and fitness. Now, if you think that this is the course for you, or you would like to have more information, please feel free to contact me via my email address, which you can see on the screen. Thanks for listening.